You ain't keeping this Sabbath day, you are breaking the Lord's covenant, and one day you're going to pay for it. You're going to pay for that for you? Because everybody want to put their stock in Paul. Skip what the Lord say. You know, just like the Lord, whatever Jesus said, it don't mean nothing compared to Paul. Go ahead and read.
Were ye baptized in the name of Paul?
He said, were you baptized in my name? Skip down to verse 17.
For Christ sent me not to baptize.
Ooh, but who sent Paul? Christ sent him. He said, he sent me not, go ahead.
But to preach the gospel.
Uh-huh.
Not with wisdom of words.
Wait a minute, he said, for Christ sent me not to baptize, but to do what? Preach the gospel. So Paul didn't send Jesus, Jesus sent Paul, right? Mm-hmm. And even Paul himself said, look, follow me as I follow Christ. Finish that.
Not with wisdom of words,
uh-huh.
Lest the cross of Christ should be made of none
effect. He said, I'm not coming with my own words, not less with the wisdom of words. You know, I'm coming with you with the wisdom of God. That's what I'm coming with you, to you with, the wisdom of the Lord. Let's go now. Let's go to Exodus, the 31st chapter. Because we're going to get to Paul, whether he kept the Sabbath or not, or did he change the Sabbath or not. We're going to Exodus 31. Exodus 31, and we're going to pick it up at verse 12. Exodus 31 and 12. Sometimes you got to put that rod of correction on. Exodus 31 and 12. Exodus 31 and 12. Go ahead and read.
And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying,
uh-huh.
Speak thou also unto the children of Israel, saying, verily my Sabbath ye shall keep.
Uh-huh.
For it is a sign between me and you throughout your generation.
It is a sign between me and you throughout your generations. We are a generation, aren't we?
Yes.
Go ahead and read.
That ye may know that I am the Lord that doth sanctify you.
Oh, when you keep the Sabbath, the Lord has sanctified you. He has set you apart. Not only has he chosen you, but he has given you a Sabbath and set you apart from everybody else.
Hallelujah.
Go ahead and read.
Ye shall keep the Sabbath therefore.
Uh-huh.
For it is holy unto you.
It is holy unto you. Go ahead.
Everyone that defileth it shall surely be put to death.
Uh-huh.
For whosoever doeth any work therein, that soul shall be cut off from among his people.
Go ahead.
6 days may work be done, but in the Sabbath is the Sabbath of rest,
uh-huh.
Holy to the Lord.
Go ahead.
Whosoever doeth any work in the Sabbath day, he shall surely be put to death.
Now this is why I really came here. Keep reading.
Wherefore the children of Israel shall keep the Sabbath,
uh-huh.
To observe the Sabbath throughout their generations,
uh-huh.
For a perpetual covenant.
Ooh, this is a perpetual covenant. Man cannot break, well, they can break covenants, but they can't do away with covenants. Paul, Peter, that's what I was trying to think of earlier, Peter. Peter, Paul, Isaiah, you understand? Moses could not do away with covenants. The Pope, he cannot do away with God's covenant. Emperor Constantine, he cannot do away with God's covenant. No man on this earth from the beginning to the end cannot do away with God's covenant. No man. Even Jesus himself told you, think not that I come to destroy the law of the prophets. Till heaven and earth pass, one jot or one tittle should in no wise pass from the law till all be fulfilled. So if Paul had came with something crazy, then I'm like, man, skip Paul. If Peter had came with something crazy, man, look, skip Peter. You understand? But they weren't coming with nothing crazy. They're the ones who told you to keep the Sabbath day. But you got these other men like Emperor Constantine, Pope Gregory, and all of these other so-called forefathers of the church giving you Sunday. And now they are arguing about all these different subjects. Just go check it out. We're going to be reading some of it in a week or two. Just go check out some of the stuff that they arguing over. All of them got it wrong. Ain't no such thing as no Trinity. Ain't no such thing as no Trinity. Ain't no such thing as God changing Sabbath day from the seventh day to the first day.
Right.
Ain't no such thing. Go ahead and read. So they said, children of Israel shall keep the Sabbath, to observe the Sabbath throughout their generations for a perpetual covenant. We are the children of Israel. We most assuredly should be keeping it, shouldn't we?
Yes, sir.
Read that last verse.
17.
Uh-huh.
It is a sign between me and the children of Israel forever.
For how long?
Forever.
For how long?
Forever.
We got to drive that point home. This is a sign between the Lord and the children of Israel forever. But that don't loose the stranger. That don't loose him either. He got to keep it too. This is for the world. This is the Sabbath is for the world. Not just for Israel. Let me show you. Let's go to Isaiah 56 chapter. Isaiah 56. This is for the world. It's not just for Israel. 56. And we're going to keep picking up at verse Isaiah 56 and 2. Isaiah 56 and 2. Go ahead and read it.
Blessed is the man that doeth this.
Uh-huh.
And the son of man that layeth hold on it.
Now he said blessed is the man. He didn't say blessed is the Israelite, did he? He said, blessed is the man that doeth this, and the son of man that layeth hold on it. Go ahead.
That keepeth the Sabbath from polluting it.
That keepeth the Sabbath from polluting it. Go ahead.
And keepeth his hand from doing any evil.
Uh-huh.
Neither let the son of the stranger that hath joined himself to the Lord speak, saying, the Lord hath utterly separated me from his people.
Isn't that what Emperor Constantine had done? Isn't that what he has tried? He has separated the Lord's people. Saying that, you know, neither let the son of the stranger that have joined himself to the Lord speak, saying, the Lord hath utterly separated me from his people. Isn't that what Emperor Constantine had done? He had told you that the Lord's Sabbath day is the first day of the week, and man have taken it lock, stock, and barrel and ran with it.
Yeah.
And now you got the preachers telling you that the Lord's Sabbath day is the first day of the week now. They say you're separate from the Lord now. You keep the first day of the week. You don't keep the Sabbath day. Go ahead and read.
Neither let the eunuch say, behold, I am a dry tree.
Go ahead.
For thus said the Lord unto the eunuchs that keep my Sabbaths, and choose the things that please me.
Go ahead.
And take hold of my covenant.
Ooh, because you know you're supposed to please the Lord, don't you? You're supposed to do the things that please him. Go ahead and read. And that covenant he talking about, that's the Ten Commandments. What's the fourth commandment? Keep the Sabbath. Go ahead and read.
Verse 5.
Uh-huh.
Even unto them will I give in my house and within my walls a place and a name better than of sons and of daughters.
Uh-huh.
I will give them an everlasting name.
Go ahead.
That shall not be cut off.
Uh-huh.
Also the sons of the stranger.
Also the sons of, who is the stranger? That's everybody other than Israel, ain't it?
Yes, sir.
Go ahead and read.
Also the sons of the stranger that joined themselves to the Lord to serve him.
That joined themselves to the Lord to serve him. See that? So now you join yourself to the Lord and serve him. If you keep it the first day of the week, the second day of the week, the third day of the week, and all that for the Sabbath.
No.
You ain't joined yourself to the Lord to serve him. Go ahead and read. Now we read book now, so don't get mad. You understand? You get mad at the Lord, not at us. Go ahead and read. Read that over.
Also the sons of the stranger that join will I bring to my holy mountain.
Uh-huh.
And make them joyful in my house of prayer.
Go ahead.
Their burnt offering and their sacrifices shall be accepted upon mine altar.
Uh-huh.
For my house shall be called a house of prayer for all people.
My house should be called a house of prayer for all people. That's our motto, ain't it?
Right. Yes, sir.
My house should be called a house of prayer for all. But you see what he said, though? The sons of the stranger, he said, I'm going to bring them to my holy mountain. You understand? So now, and then he said, if you want to serve him, and then by serving him, you don't pollute the Sabbath. If you pollute the Sabbath today and doing all those things which you want to, you pollute the Sabbath, then you're not a servant of the Lord then, are you?
That's real.
I mean, this, we're reading the facts, right? This the deciding factor right here is the Bible, ain't it? So So whatever the Bible says, that's the way it is.
Right.
Let's go to Psalms, the 42nd chapter. Psalms 42. So he said, the sons of the stranger, if they want to serve me, they got to keep the Sabbath too. Psalms 42, and we're going to pick up in verse 1. Psalm 42 and 1. Go ahead and read it.
As the hart panteth after the water brooks, so panteth my soul after thee, O God.
See, that's we panting after God, aren't we? Yeah. That's why we're here on the Sabbath. That's why we try during the week to do everything. Forgive me, Lord, for doing this, or forgive me, Lord, for doing that. That's why we're praying all the time. Forgive me, Lord, for help me, Lord, to curve my mouth.
Right.
You understand? Help me, Lord, with my attitude. Go ahead and read.
My soul thirsteth for God, for the living God. When shall I come and appear before God?
Go ahead.
My tears have been my meat day and night, while they continually say unto me, where is thy God?
Go ahead.
When I remember these things, I pour out my soul in me. For I had gone with the multitude.
I had gone with the multitude. Where'd they go?
I went up with them to the house of God.
I went up to them with to the house of God. Go ahead and read.
With the voice of joy and praise. With the multitude that kept holy day.
With the multitude that kept holy day. And that's why we're here. We're coming to the house of God to keep the holy day. And this Sabbath day is a holy day, ain't it?
Yes.
It's a holy day. Not only is it holy to us, but it's also holy to God.
Hallelujah.
The first day of the week, he never called that holy to him.
No.
Let's go now. Let's go back down to the first century. Let's go to Acts the 18th chapter. Now this is Paul now. Acts 18. Everybody's beloved Paul. And I'm not talking about Paul or nothing like that, because Paul was a righteous brother. He confused. He got a lot of people confused, though. But it's to their own destruction. If you listen to the prophets and the master, then you don't get confused, will you? We had Acts 18 and 1. Let's see what Paul did. He keep the Sabbath? Acts 18 and 1. Go ahead and read it.
After these things, Paul departed from Athens and came to Corinth. And found a certain Jew named Aquila, born in Pontus, lately come from Italy, with his wife Priscilla, because that Claudius had commanded all Jews to depart from Rome, and came unto them.
Go ahead.
And because he was of the same craft, he abode with them and wrought, for by their occupation they were tent makers.
Verse 4, what did it say?
And he reasoned in the synagogue every Sabbath.
And he reasoned in the synagogue, what? Every Sabbath. Now, how can you get around this? Now, you see, they go and take two times that Paul now went and taught the people on the first day of the week. Two times you see that in the Bible. But they totally ignore this right here where Paul went and taught every Sabbath. They totally ignore this. Now, what you gonna do with this? You understand? He went into the synagogue every Sabbath. What did he do?
And persuaded the Jews and the Greeks.
Ooh, he was persuading the Jews and the Greeks. Now, what you going to do with this? See, people don't read this. They go to Sunday church. They don't read nothing like this. They tell you they New Testament Christians, and then they tell you, well, we Acts of the Apostles. That's what we follow. Well, what the apostles say right here?
Right.
He reasoned in the synagogue every Sabbath, persuading the Jews and the Greeks. What you going to do with that? You only see him going to teaching the people on the first day of the week twice. You totally ignore the fact that he went into the synagogue every Sabbath, persuading not only the Jews, but the Greeks too. But hold on 1 minute, though. Hold on to your seat. Hold on. Let's go now. Let's go to Acts the 13th chapter. Acts 13. People talking about the Israelites. Now, we're dealing with the first century Christians. This is around 60-something AD. And then you got Emperor Constantine in like 300 and something AD. So it's like 300 year difference right here we're dealing with. This ain't that far, is it?